I have this friend. He's kind of my little brother. My wife also sometimes, from time to time. His name is Emile Parisien. He's a saxophone player, and I spent the past 5 years on the road with him a lot. And he has wrote this tune called "Le Clown Tueur de la Fête Foraine." So I will translate because you won't understand anything either. So this is the killer clown from the party. Okay. So it's a kind of a song full of hope, you can imagine. So on the contrary, I decided to write another song called "Le Clown Sauveur de la Fête Foraine," which means the saver clown from the party. Nice. End of the story, you know? Bye-bye. Usually, for the title, I'm so bad. I'm really bad. So, for example, B&H, it's a tune I wrote for Michel Portal, of the French clarinet player. And I was just thinking about two people he used to work with, as Boyan Z, so Boyan B.
B, yes.
And Henri Texier, so H.
Player.
So the title, B&H. It's nicht so schlecht, but it's nothing special.
There's also a funny title called, like, did you say Rothenberg?
Yes.
I heard you rehearsing this morning, mm-hmm, with a big band, and you are very much into detail working with the band. You really try to make them understand every part. You go to musicians to talk to them and to tell them, look, this has to be this way and this way. And they react quite fast, right?
Yes. For German, you mean? I'm kidding. No, but about the details, it's because... What I'm writing, it could be really dangerous. I mean, for me, because it could be really borderline about the bad taste and good taste. So if you don't get into details, you will play the song and it won't be good. I mean, because I know the way I'm writing. When you just read it, it's like, all right. So I don't know if it sounds good, but if you go into the details, the volume, the phrasing, it makes really the difference. And then the shitty tunes become not so bad.
I think each song has its own history, and also each arrangement. I mean, arrangement is more or less very related to composition, and you need always inspiration. But I remember, because I was actually in Colombia when I was written most of the arrangements. So, for instance, one song, Vincent was also very much open to say, oh, you know what, you can feel free, but don't do that. No, but that was great. He said, you can definitely, I would like to be surprised. And then I was, one song especially, I really felt to go into the Colombian mood, this Le Cirque de la Mirage. So it has a lot of different, I mean, I guess the story is about some circus. And then, so in this kind of arrangement, we go through the circus, and we go to Colombia, and then we go to Art Blakey Jazz Messengers, and then we go back to the circus. So that one for me was fun in that way to do it. And then we have other songs like Did You Say Rothenberg? That is a fantastic song in the first place with the whole mood, and it fits so well the instrumentation for the whole band. So I can there's a story about each song, definitely.